Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we will discuss Roisenmann reduction. This reduction involves the preparation of aldehydes from acyl chlorides. So fact number one is it is the conversion of acyl chloride to aldehyde. So Roisenmann reduction involves the conversion of acyl chloride to corresponding aldehyde, and the reduction involves a reagent that is called Roisenmann reagent. So point number two is what is Roisenmann reagent? It is hydrogen adsorbed on the surface of palladium metal with the barium sulfate. Hydrogen is a gas adsorbed on the metal surface. Metal is palladium. And what is the role of barium sulfate? Barium sulfate here acts as a catalytic poison. It controls the reductional capacity of hydrogen. H2 with palladium metal with hydrogen acts as a strong reducing agent. But here barium sulfate controls the reductional activity of hydrogen. So it acts as a catalytic poison. If we don't use barium sulfate, then aldehyde will not form. The major product will be alcohol. Aldehyde will further reduced by the activity of hydrogen adsorbed on the surface of palladium. So catalytic poison controls the reductional activity of hydrogen. So we can say it is partial hydrogenation. Roisenmann reduction is it is a partial hydrogenation of acyl chloride to corresponding aldehyde. Actually, in Roisenmann reagent, some other catalytic poisons are also used, and those are sodium acetate, thiourea, and quinoline. Some other used poisons are sodium acetate, thiourea, and quinoline. All these control the reactivity of hydrogen, make it available for only partial hydrogenation. Otherwise, the major product will form be alcohol, and even alcohol will further reduce to alkane. So that is the important point. What is the role of barium sulfate? It acts as a catalytic poison. And how it acts as a catalytic poison? For example, we have metal surface palladium. It has pores, atoms of palladium. So some pores are occupied by hydrogen. Hydrogen is adsorbed on the surface of palladium, but barium sulfate occupies some voids of some pores of palladium. For example, these are occupied by barium sulfate. So these porous structure is occupied by barium sulfate. So hydrogen will not available. Hydrogen will be available only to a small extent. That is the role of barium sulfate. And similarly, other poisons, they also play the same role. They control the reactivity of hydrogen, making it available only for a partial hydrogenation. So sodium acetate, thiourea, and quinoline, they also act as a catalytic poison. So now how this reaction proceed? First, acid is converted into acid chloride, and acid chloride
in presence of Rosenmund catalyst converted into aldehyde.
So first we will convert acid to acid chloride and acid chloride to corresponding aldehydes. So
for example, we have acid RCOOH,
any carboxylic acid.
It can be converted into acid chloride by the use of thionyl chloride, by the action of PCl5, by the action of PCl3, or by the action of HCl with anhydrous zinc chloride.
They all will provide nucleophile chlorine that will displace this OH. From all these sources,
we will get Cl negative and it will displace OH. So we will obtain
RCOCl. So this is our acyl chloride or acid chloride group. Now it reacts with the
Rosenmund reagent H2 with palladium and with the barium sulfate.
So HCl will eliminate and we will get only aldehyde.
RCOH minus HCl.
So this is actually partial hydrogenation of acyl chloride or acid chloride to aldehyde. If we don't use barium sulfate, then reaction will be first aldehyde will form. Now this aldehyde will be further reduced to corresponding alcohol. So aldehyde is reduced to alcohol, and if we continue the reaction,
the major product will be
alkane. Right, that is the important use of barium sulfate in this reaction, to control the reactivity of hydrogen, to control the reductional capacity, reductional power of hydrogen. Actually, it is only partial hydrogenation. Right, so that's it for Rosenmund reduction. I hope you would understand it. Thanks.